Well, we stunned those guys and they're gone. Central core is here.
Phaser's on stun.
Uh-oh. Same. Phaser on stun.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Captain, are you certain that is where you wish to aim the phaser?
Can't he turn around and use that on us as well?
The floor. These monitors display ship's external sensor systems.
The ceiling.
A depression in the ceiling.
Hmm. Ceiling's depressed.
Oh, that's even worse than the damn transporter.
Yeah, we need our red shirt back. What the hell?
A door leading back into the main corridor. The main viewing screen. The station's weapon controls.
Weapon controls?
The station's communications station. One of Monroe's assistants. Dr. Monroe.
Hmm.
This seems pointless.
Pointless. Oh yeah, I didn't look at us yet.
An annoyed James T. Kirk. Mr. Spock. As emotionless as ever.
That's the problem with just stunning people, but if we kill them, that'll probably bring down our score for the episode.
An annoyed Leonard McCoy.
We're all annoyed.
An unconscious Vardane guard.
How are they doing?
Young genetically altered human male.
Ooh.
Currently unconscious.
Sorry, I'm not sure what's going on here with the... That's better.
Don't annoy me. I'm not in a good mood right now.
What are you talking to me?
The controls are quite advanced, Captain. Most impressive piece of technology. Can't we just blow up this weapon and be done with it?
Let's talk to assistant first.
Don't hurt me! Please! And could someone do something for my allergies?
Should we? He's doing something for his allergies. Okay. Maybe.
Hold still. That should help. And try to calm down. We're the good guys.
Right. That was a heavy pixelated McCoy heading right for us for a second. What does he have to say now?
Thank you for helping me with my allergies. I guess not all Federation people are bad.
Well,
oh my God.
We normally like to think of ourselves as humanitarians.
Unfortunately, that is not what Dr. Burdell tells most Vardane. Anyway, I guess I should get rid of that creeper.
Get rid of that creeper. I wonder if he gets picked on a lot by Burdell.
How dare you come aboard this station and disturb our delicate work, you Starfleet brute?
And I thought Harry Mudd was annoying.
We dare very much.
How dare you come aboard this station and disturb...
And I thought Harry Mudd was annoying. Middle-aged male human in average physical condition.
And how's he doing?
The shot I gave him should help his allergies somewhat.
Okay, so we have more help with this guy. Well, let's analyze everything else.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
No? Weapons, Spock.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
It's all weapons.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Fine, Mr. Spock. Yeah, work on these weapons then, I guess. What's that on the floor? A banana?
I am disabling their weapons control. I do not detect access to anything around the proto-event.
What is this?
This seems pointless.
He stands in front of it.
I do not see the logic in that action.
Hold on a second.
Captain, I programmed the destructive sequence into the weapons control. It would require an engineering team to repair it.
That's his, like, beret, isn't it?
I am disabling their communications network. We will now have a clear channel to the Enterprise.
Okay, before he gets over here, quick, get this thing.
No effect.
Alright, whatever. So now we can hail the Enterprise.
I do not see the logic in that action. I do not see the logic in that action.
What's his little screen here? Can we look at this?
Dr. Monroe seems to be constantly monitoring data from the console in his chair. Dr. Monroe.
Alright, let's try to hail the Enterprise then.
Kirk to Enterprise. Kirk to Enterprise.
Transmission detected in Central Command. Security forces converge on Central Command.
Captain Kirk, is everything alright?
Things are looking up, I think. Kirk out.
Well, we're gonna have more guards coming, possibly. Can these guys help me
at
all?
Thank you for helping me with my allergies. I guess not.
Well, we normally...
Unfortunately, that is not what Dr.
Yeah, okay, let's leave. Can we go in here?
The door is locked, Jim.
Let's save over this.
Save new game. Cancel. Save replace.
Oh no, this one. What about in here now?
Jim, what's that smell?
Wanaka gas. A knockout gas with an extremely long effect.
We have mere seconds to neutralize it or get out of here.
Let's get out of here. Okay, maybe now that we've actually done that, maybe we can ask him about this gas. Maybe we can shut off the gas. Oh, these guys aren't attacking us.
We have nothing to say. If you execute us, the Vardane code requires you to inform our family. The mortuary frequency is bandwidth 54.37 centimeters. Aim your transmission at Mount Arius on Vardane. Failure to comply will result in a blood feud between my family and yours until either has been completely destroyed.
A charming culture.
We have nothing to say.
Same.
If you...
A charming culture.
A Vardane guard. A Vardane guard.
Are they going to attack us?
I do not see the logic in that action. My tricorder detects nothing unusual. I suggest using Dr. McCoy's tricorder instead.
Just in case there's something about that. These guys are genetically modified?
Young genetically altered human male. Excellent physical condition.
How dare you come aboard this station and disturb our delicate
woman? I thought Harry Mudd.
Thank you for helping me with my allergy.
Well, we normally like...
Unfortunately, that is not what Dr. Bradell...
Okay, we have to remember, we couldn't get access to the security room, is the one, right? And the transporter is locked, but we could access computer room and central control. Let's try. We're probably gonna be placed into the hallway anyway, but
the floor is marked with a tricolor grid. A weary James T. Kirk.
Getting tired now?
Spock looks unperturbed, even with the imminent destruction of the Federation. McCoy wishes he was back on board the Enterprise.
Yeah, that'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Be careful. This looks too quiet. Well, Spock, what do you suggest?
We should attempt to gather evidence that Dr. Bradell is planning to commit genocide. Others may help us if they are confronted with the scope of Bridell's misdeeds. We need to shut down the tractor beam that is currently holding the Enterprise. Our chief priority is to find the reason for the Holocaust that was reported by the...
I'm afraid that the social Darwinists have never impressed me, Jim. Building a better human on the inside is far more preferable to improving his physical traits.
Originally, Doctor, Vardane was a very harsh environment. The Vardane claimed that the original human settlers required genetic engineering to survive.
Living only to survive is a poor life indeed, Spock.
That is true.
Well, Spock, what do you suggest?
We need to shut down our chief priority.
Same?
Be careful. This looks too quiet.
Okay, I forgot what he said. Let's look here. We have... We can input something, possibly. Here.
There is a numeric entry code next to Bridell's door. The wall looks very solid.
Okay, what's this?
This door is labeled Crew Quarters.
Let's save, just in case something horrible happens.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
When we enter Crew Quarters. Provided it isn't locked.
Rather cramped living quarters. Only a small step up from Klingon ships.
No wonder the Klingons have such a bad temper.
We'd better be quiet. There's a gentleman on the bed who might quarrel with us if we wake him up.
Well, what the hell is this? Mannequins? That's actually kind of creepy looking.
A Vardane guard, currently asleep. The floor.
In the past, I would always aim at the floor to get a general description of the room. That doesn't work now.
This seems pointless. A target for laser firing practice. A small, shifting holographic bullseye is certain to challenge even the most skilled marksman. A bed. It appears to be designed for slightly larger than man-sized humanoids.
What the hell are these?
Practice dummies for martial arts.
Ah, okay.
This seems pointless. A food synthesizer.
Nice.
Ventilation ducts in the wall. Narrow channels covered by a steel mesh grid. Storage modules. Storage modules. A light mounted in the ceiling. This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
So pointless.
A panel in the wall.
Okay. You know, I wonder if it was like this in the first game. When it lights up red around it, that means something you can actually look at.
The wall looks very solid.
Of course, that doesn't mean it's anything worth looking at.
A very quiet James T. Kirk.
Let sleeping guards lie.
Dr. McCoy, more subdued than usual. A stoic and silent Mr. Spock.
I had forgotten how Spartan the Vardane could be.
An excellent analogy, Captain. The Vardane consider art to be an activity of limited utility at best, and subversive at worst.
Well, you know art can be pretty damn strange, and it's human nature to fear what you don't understand. Vardane nature too, I guess.
True dat, McCoy. True dat.
And I thought that our quarters in the Enterprise were cramped.
I wonder if there's anything here we can use.
So do I.
My tricorder can only scan people sleeping in beds.
Huh?
Not the beds themselves.
I'm trying to aim at the person. Thank you.
No wonder he's not on duty. He's suffering from Cervix toxemia. He must have spent some time on Rigel 8.
Think he'll get up?
He's under heavy medication, Jim, but with Verdane physiology, you can never tell.
Can we heal him even further?
This will keep him unconscious. I can't cure him with a med kit. His infection is not easily treatable.
That's what I figured. Well, good thing he'll stay unconscious. I kind of like that idea. Let's analyze stuff, Mr. Spock.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Oh, come on.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. Nothing unusual about...
Come on.
Ventilation ducts, Captain. The atmosphere they are circulating is within acceptable parameters for humanoid life forms.
Hmm. About the beds, I guess not.
An ordinary bed, Captain.
What is this thing, also?
No anomalous readings, Captain.
Okay, should we, play with this thing?
The target is firmly attached to the wall.
I'm gonna mess with the mannequins.
The dummies are not easy to carry, but you manage.
How are we carrying these exactly? What do you do, stuff them in his pants? Huh?
Training dummies for martial arts practice.
Indeed. And what is this again, up here?
The wall looks very solid.
Oh, just wall?
The wall looks very solid.
Solid, yes. What if I shoot the wall? The target.
Captain, they might track us by phaser discharges. I strongly recommend against using them, unless absolutely necessary.
You know, it's not really hard to look for us throughout the ship. There's only like 8 rooms we can go in, besides where it came from. anything else here?
This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
It seems pointless. Can we open these ventilation ducts?
Jim, if we remove the filter, we may be subjecting the patient to unnecessary risk.
I tend to agree with Dr. McCoy. The ventilation channels on this station are too small for us to use as passages. We cannot use them to avoid the Vardane. Therefore, removing them is an inefficient use of our time.
Okay, fine. What about this?
Fluorescent lighting. Old-fashioned, but practical.
Can I do anything with anything? Let's just try the general...
The mat is firmly attached to the floor.
What's this here?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
The wall's peeling aside.
No, I don't think that's necessary. He already looks down for the count. The inventory just registers articles of clothing. The inventory just registers articles of clothing.
I don't think I can reach that high.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
What is Bones saying?
I don't think I can reach that high.
The target is firmly attached to the wall.
The station is solidly constructed, but rather sterile. Even the wall looks harsh.
What's this here?
Seems to be broken.
Gotta walk all the way back over there. What is this again?
A food synthesizer.
Oh, yeah, food. Okay, I'm not sure if there's anything else in here we can get. So far, so good.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Let's try...
This door is labeled Executive Quarters.
Let's try the door labeled Executive Quarters. Interesting sounds.
The floor. This appears to be a synthesis between a computer and a musical instrument.
A cochlea. How rare.
What is it?
It has many uses, Bones, but it's most commonly used as a mood inducer. It emits subsonic vibrations at a wavelength that stimulates the emotional centers of the human brain.
Maybe we could use it on the Vardane.
The effects of a cochlean are not significant enough to radically change emotional states. If it had such abilities, logic would suggest it would have wide use as a narcotic.
Well, that's one great plan that's gone down in flames.
A plant?
A large potted plant is hanging from the wall.
Somebody has a green thumb here.
You mean to tell me there are Verdane who are interested in something other than eugenics or military conquest?
Bakata Sheen was proof of that. Unfortunately, it cost him much.
Oh.
Oh. What are these?
A selection of bound technical printouts. One of the technicians really loves his work.
Well, that's good.
This seems pointless.
That seems pointless.
An external monitor used by central control to send messages to this room.
Hmm.
An external monitor.
Okay, they're both external monitors. What's this?
This is a wall cabinet.
Hmm.
This is a wall cabinet.
This is a couch.
A comfortable pseudo-leather chair. Library monitors. These data screens provide information and entertainment for board executives.
Hmm.
A bed. A bed.
A bed. A bed.
Mr. Spock eyes the instrument on the rear wall with interest.
Which one? This?
A food synthesizer.
Another food synthesizer.
An atmospheric purifier. It is capable of removing contaminants from large quantities of air or water in less than a second. It carries the brand of the Save-A-Ship Manufacturing Corporation.
Now, why would you need an atmosphere purifier on a space station? The filter should be built into the life support system.
I suspect it could help someone with extreme allergies.
James Kirk seems relieved to find the room deserted. McCoy wonders if there is a medical doctor aboard this facility.
Want to compare notes?
This seems pointless. The door leads back to the corridor.
Okay. Talk?
Does anyone have any suggestions?
Nope. Not unless you click on them. What is this over here, by the way? I just noticed that. Oh, wait. I wanted to do that.
This seems pointless.
Alright, it's pointless.
Well, Bones, do you have any ideas?
I'm not a religious man, Jim. But a few prayers couldn't hurt us right now.
Spock?
We should attempt to gather evidence that Dr. Burdell is planning to commit genocide.
Same as before.
I've heard about these. Let's try...
Play some Skinner, man.
Sorry, Bones. I must have hit the key that stimulates the pain center. Well, I wonder if there's anything useful in this data bank.
Negative, Captain. The database contains common entertainment and informational programs. It does not access any of the station's other computers.
Hmm.
This chair looks comfortable.
Cabinets.
It's locked.
The filter is bulky but portable.
Ah, I got the filter.
I don't think I'm hungry right now.
Haha. Are you sleepy?
Jim, I don't think this is the time to be sleeping on the job.
Haha.
Scotty would love to get his hands on these.
He probably has them already.
I do not have enough experience on the instrument, Captain. I do not believe that it would be advisable. The database contains common entertainment and informational programs. There is no link to any of Burdell's other files.
Hmm.
I do not need to sit down, Captain.
Can you open these, Spock?
I am unable to unlock it, Captain. It has a brain path scan lock. Only someone with specific brain patterns could unlock this.
Hmm.
I do not require food at this time, Captain. I do not see the logic in that action. A cursory glance at the titles indicates that they are relatively unimportant. A technical schematic of a Save-A-Ship air filter. Some variant transporter technology. Nothing out of the ordinary.
So yeah, the Save-A-Ship... company is the same one who they make, yeah, is it the same? Atmospheric, oh no, was it life support system that Harry Mudd was using in the first game?
I do not see the logic in that action.
You're sleepy, Spock.
The pot and its holder are firmly attached to the wall.
What about you, Bones?
Ah, that looks comfortable. These Vardane aren't Spartans, Jim. I don't understand any of this, Jim. Mother McCoy didn't raise her baby boy to be a safecracker, Jim.
The correct line is, I'm a safecracker. No, wait. I'm not a safecracker, I'm a doctor. Yeah, that one.
I don't understand any of this, Jim. Jim, have you ever heard me play the violin?
No, Bones, why?
If you had, you wouldn't let me within 10 kilometers of a musical instrument.
We need a person. Maybe if we heal this guy, he'll come and use his brain to open this, and he can play that.
I wonder how much medical information are in these files. I am hungry.
Bones, one of the Vardane's tricks when there is an escaped prisoner is to make sure that all food synthesizers produce drugged food.
Very
one
good.
One bite, and you'll be sleeping for the next 12 hours.
Well, I guess I'm full. May I ask how you obtained that knowledge, Captain?
This isn't the first time I've been an escaped prisoner at the Vardane, Mr. Spock.
Right, right. I guess nothing else to do here? Let's look at our item.
A SavaShip brand air filter. Used by people with extreme allergic reaction.
So perhaps we can use that in the other room and then go through the thing. Isn't it the vent still too small for us to crawl through? In any case, it's a possibility. Maybe we could just improve his condition that way. Before I do anything, let's just save again.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Alright, what else do we have?
This door is labeled Ease Bradell.
Ease Bradell.
This door is labeled Special Projects Room.
I want to check out the Special Projects Room. Oh my! They got Goro in there. Goro! Finish him. Maybe we play the music to soothe the savage beast.
This seems pointless. A large machine. It looks like the center of an experiment.
What is this thing?
A mutated Antarian man-killer.
Oh my.
An improved version of one of the most feared animals in the galaxy. This seems pointless.
Yeah, I aimed there.
Some sort of special project controls. Very bulky with a lot of prototype components. It is currently protected by a force field.
According to my tricorder, Captain, the power system for this force field originates from the security section.
Which is locked at this point. We don't have access to.
A chair.
A chair.
A large machine. It looks like the center of an experiment. This seems pointless. A communication panel. A communication panel.
What about this?
This seems pointless.
This
seems pointless.
Alright, all pointless.
This seems pointless.
Wires?
This seems pointless.
Stuff?
A large machine.
You know, Jim, I really could have done without meeting this thing.
Come on, Bones, it'll build character.
I have quite enough character, thank you very much.
I forgot to look at them.
Dr. McCoy looks at the equipment, wondering when his services will be needed. Mr. Spock looks at the equipment. James Kirk, he's a little hungry right now.
Don't eat the food, Kirk!
You know, Jim, I really could have done without meeting this thing.
Come on, Bones, it'll build character.
All right. I have quite enough character.
Nice looking animal.
A most deadly beast. Almost as deadly as some of the predators on Vulcan.
Greetings.
I think that's I'm going to do horrible things to your anatomy in the language of the Antarian man-killers.
Excellent. Analyze this thing's well, this life form.
My God, it's not just an Antarian man-killer. You should see some of the genetic engineering they've done to it. They've actually made it deadlier.
A formidable achievement in genetics, Doctor. Given that the species is renowned throughout the galaxy as one of the most powerful and dangerous predators in known space.
There are reasons why the Federation monitors genetic research, and this thing is one of them.
Hmm.
The device appears to be involved in genetic research, Captain. It inserts mutagens into genes and monitors their progress. The device is empty.
I bet you'll find genetic residue that they used to add to our warm and cuddly friend over there.
Hmm, indeed.
This is the control for the special weapon that is holding the Enterprise. A force field prevents our access to the controls. Captain, my tricorder indicates that the force field controls can be neutralized in the station's security center.
Right, which we still haven't gotten access to.
I detect a great deal of augmentation in the creature's anatomy, Captain.
Hmm.
The panel is fully functioning. It is linked to several locations on the ship, including one which is highly shielded.
Okay, Spock, do your thing. And hopefully not let this thing get out.
I recommend against using the station's communications unless absolutely necessary.
Okay, what about this thing?
I cannot say that I've ever encountered this technology before, Captain.
Don't get yourself vaporized.
Captain, the force field surrounding these controls prevents my access.
Hmm.
I detect a great deal of augmentation.
Okay, not sure what to do there.